perform jugular blood draw on a calf, you will need either a 20-gauge needle and syringe or a blood collection tube and a 20-gauge needle and needle holder. The needle should be an inch in length. In this video, we are using a blood collection tube and needle. You may also want alcohol wipes to wet the calf's coat. This allows for better visualization of the blood vessel. When performing a jugular blood draw, you can restrain the calf in a standing or laying position. In this video, we will demonstrate both ways of restraining a calf. When restraining a calf that is lying down, one person will straddle the calf and turn the neck to one side. The person that is drawing the blood will use one hand to block the vein at the base of the jugular furrow, allowing the blood to build up in the vein. In this video, the vein is blocked by the left hand, while the right hand is used to feel for the vein. When pressure on the vein is released by the left hand, the vein collapses. Once you have found the vein, insert the needle at a 45-degree angle. If a blood collection tube is used, the blood will be drawn into the tube once the needle is in the vein. It is important to note that if the needle is removed from the vein while the blood collection tube is attached, you will lose the vacuum in the tube and will not be able to use it to draw blood any longer. To restrain the calf in a standing position, you want to place the calf so there is a solid panel along the calf's side and behind it so it cannot back up while you are holding it. The person restraining the calf will place their back leg against the animal's back flank and front leg against the shoulder. This allows the calf's head to be turned across the leg of the restrainer. Steps for drawing the blood from a standing calf are the same as for a calf that is laying down. Start by blocking the vein at the base of the jugular furrow, allowing it to fill with blood. Insert your needle at a 45-degree angle and attach the blood collecting tube. Once you have obtained the necessary amount of blood, remove the blood tube from the needle and remove the needle from the vein. Use a finger to apply slight pressure on the injection site to help stop any blood flow.